Mary Magdalene told the good news, Jesus lives. But to the disciples, it doesn't sound like good news at all. On the first day of the week at early dawn, the women who came with Jesus from Galilee arrive at his tomb with spices to embalm his body. They are prepared for a day of grief. Instead, these women find the tomb open and Jesus's body is gone. Two dazzling figures share these incredible words. Why do you look for the living among the dead? Jesus is not here, but has risen. Remember how he told you while he was still in Galilee, the Son of Humanity must be handed over to sinners and be crucified and on the third day rise again. Awe and excitement fill Mary Magdalene and Joanna and Mary, the mother of James, and all who are with them, until this crowd of women bursts in on a room full of mourning disciples to share everything. But whatever words these women find, they're not recorded in our scriptures. Whatever stories they put together seem to the disciples to be nothing but an idle tale. Have you ever heard a story that's too good to be true? Most of us have learned to be skeptical about the stories that we hear, the stories that we read, the pictures and the videos that we see. We have learned that every person has their own point of view. Every news source has its bias. Lies abound, and many of them are malicious. We are wise to be wary in case someone is trying to manipulate us or take us for a fool. Life teaches us that we should be especially skeptical about surprisingly good news. Many stories don't have happy endings. Terrible things sometimes happen for no good reason at all. Hearts that are familiar with grief and disappointment, hope may seem like nothing but vulnerability. No wonder that the women who arrive with embalming spices need holy messengers to help them understand the empty tomb. No wonder that the disciples grieving the assassination of their leader think the women's words an idle tale. Hope after so much loss can feel unbearable. And the disciples have been taught, as we have been taught, not to believe in the words of women. There are so many reasons not to believe the message of these holy figures that appear at the tomb and the stories of the women on that first Easter morning. To consider the Easter tale an idle one. And yet this shockingly good news is entirely consistent with how God operates. Our scriptures and traditions teach us that our God is a God of holy surprises and strange reversals. That if we were alert, we will notice God in the most unexpected places. In little things like a mustard seed or a grain of yeast or a lily or a still small voice. In great things like the fall of an empire or the movements of wave and wind in a storm. In personal things like a vocational calling or a family reconciliation. And in public things, in political things like the sick being healed and the hungry being fed, and people being freed from all kinds of bondage. God is at work in all things, in all kinds of people, love and liberation emerging to make ways out of no way. And God is even and especially with people with the least power and in places of the greatest devastation. God grieves with us there, and help us to imagine that even here, even now, after the death or the divorce or the diagnosis, after the bombing or the betrayal, new hope and new life and new meaning can arise. Who could have guessed? We should have guessed, even if we had not been told ahead of time. The story of Jesus does not end at the cross and the grave, but with an empty tomb, with a strange opening up of possibility that feels almost painful. What would you have thought if you had heard the news on that first Easter morning? How do you feel hearing it today? Is it easy to affirm that Jesus rose, that love is stronger than destruction and death, that love always rises again? Or does your heart struggle with the twist in the story, with the possibility beyond the tragedy, even thousands of years later? Does all of this seem like an idle tale? Those who were closest to Jesus weren't at all sure what to think. Their gift isn't certainty, but curiosity. When the women share their story, Simon Peter doesn't say, "I believe you, it must be true." But he does get up. He gets up and he runs to the tomb, just in case. Just in case it might have happened in the way that they said. And when he sees the empty tomb, he is amazed. He lets wonder and possibility fill his heart. To follow Jesus, to be reborn and reformed day by day into a deeper life, we need not be certain. Certainty can even be a barrier, convincing us that we know everything we need to know about God or the world. Better to be open. Better to be curious. Better to keep paying attention so that we may witness for ourselves the resurrections that God is bringing about in our lives and in the world around us. Please pray with me. Holy God, holy mystery, when we hear a word of hope, a word of life, a word of love, it feels safer to assume it is a lie, an idle tale. Grant us the grace to stay curious, so that we might learn and relearn your wisdom and your ways, so that we might witness wonders we might otherwise have missed, so that you might rise again in us today and every day. Amen.